Welcome back into Penguins Live Weekly. Obviously, the big news this morning, the contract extension for Matt Murray. 3 years for the 22-year-old netminder. Certainly another savvy move from Jim Rutherford.
I think it's good for Matt and good for the Penguins to get it done. And we're very happy to have him in the fold.
Yeah, I'm thrilled, obviously. You know, Pittsburgh is a great place to play. Anybody in their right mind would want to be here. So, yeah, for that more confidence, it's awesome, and I'm really thrilled.
When you get that confidence from the management, the organization, so it's always a nice feeling.
You know, we're very fortunate to have both Mark and Matt, two guys that we can depend on that are going to backstop us in goal. We feel like we've got a competitive advantage there each and every night, regardless of which guy's in.
The Penguins' golden anniversary has revealed some golden memories. Reflecting on seeing something for the first time is always special. So in mid-October, the Penguins welcomed back the first players in franchise history.
Chuck, how are you? How's everything with you?
Good, good.
Good, good to see you again. Yeah. Things have changed, right? Yeah. Oh. Nice building and the whole work.
You should see the practice. It's unreal.
Isn't it? Yeah, they want to get a team photo.
You know, better get in the back row.
Yeah.
You know what's amazing for me coming back here? Like, when I came here early, it was like a little New York.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It was exciting and all that. Then they had the downturn. But you know, a city like Pittsburgh never stays down.
Right.
Because of the people here,
right.
I think.
That's right.
And look what it's turned into. Yeah. I mean, it's marvelous. It's
my really nice. First wife named the team.
Yeah, what a great name, too. And then when we were in the igloo.
Right.
So that was, you know, perfect. I'll never forget this town.
Please join the entire Penguins organization in welcoming these distinguished alumni home. Thank you for all your contributions, not only for our franchise, but to the game of hockey.
All these faces from the past, they might look a little different, but the personalities and whatnot haven't changed. And coming back here, having an opportunity to see how things have evolved, it's truly great.
Throws it out to Dailey from left side over to Ian Cole. Rich shot, score! Cole shot the puck. I don't know if it was touched or not on the way in. And the Penguins take the lead on a 53-foot shot by Ian Cole.
It's just been an incredible night. To see all the old guys, it's like a big reunion for us. Like it's been incredible.
Jumping into the Penguins' end, Letang around 2 seconds to go to the near side. Penguins have it. It finishes 3-2 Pittsburgh as the Ducks never get a chance to get the tying goal on the final 30 seconds.
Reliving the past can often serve as a fountain of youth. But the current-day Penguins do not have that luxury. After early success to start the season, the team faced some adversity for the first time.
When you're in this league, you never want to lose too many. It's certainly a long season, but we want to make sure that we're winning games here early on, because the closer you get to the playoffs, the harder those points become.
When things aren't going your way, I think guys are just trying to kind of help each other and talk back and forth about things we want to be able to do better and give guys hints and things like that. And I think each guy in the locker room just tries to work that much harder just to maybe just get an extra bounce or two.
You know, that was maybe not the best way to end the game. You know, I wasn't the best player there is, but at the end you lose the game, it's still frustrating, you know, so you kind of go over the game what you could have done different.
Deflect and it goes in, over the shoulder, and it's a game winner.
It's important that you control the things within your power to try to get a positive result, and we certainly don't want to be a team that puts ourselves at a disadvantage early in the season by not controlling what we can in the win-loss column.
At the start of the year, we're still, you know, trying to get it together a little bit. Shears and Tanger go down. Those are two guys that you rely on a lot. So, you know, I think we're still trying to find ourselves a bit. You know, we knew it was there, and, you know, were a couple tough games.
The National Hockey League presents the Pittsburgh Penguins and the San Jose Sharks.
You know, the first two periods of that game weren't good at all. We were struggling, and in the intermission just said, let's just go and play like we know how.
Chopped away, knocked away, Malkin's got it, he shoots and scores! Evgeny Malkin!
Towards the end of that game, we kind of really found ourselves, and our ability to come together as a team in times like that showed, and it's awesome to see everybody kind of just come together like that.
I think that's probably the art of coaching as opposed to the science of coaching, is trying to make sure that you send the right messages at the right time so that our team can respond the right way. The response in that San Jose game was the right one for us to get back in the win column.
Often referred to as the ageless wonder, veteran Matt Cullen became only the 59th player in history to play in 1,300 NHL games.
He brings so much experience, and he's still an unbelievable player. It's crazy, like, I haven't even played 300. He's over 1,300 now, but we're pretty lucky to have him on our squad.
Well, he's an invaluable part of this team. Our coaching staff looks at Cully almost as an extension of our coaching staff. I think the players have great respect for him in the room. When he speaks, I think they listen.
He's awesome. I stood by him in the locker room, you know, and it's fun. Like, he's a guy you can ask pretty much anything about hockey life, and I'm glad we got him on our team.
You learn so much from him just on a day-to-day basis, and over the course of a season you learn how to handle yourself, you learn how to do certain things, and recognizing how long and how good of a career he's had is something special.
For a hockey player, playing games is nothing new. So when EA Sports came to film them playing themselves, naturally some ribbing ensued, especially after the producer called Justin Schultz Jeff.
For some reason, people, if they mistake my name, it's always Jeff. And the guy there, he did that. And then obviously, when you're around Bones, he's not going to let it go.
We're playing EA Sports NHL 17 against Bang Bang Crystal Tang and Jeff Schultz. So.
I am Crystal Tang.
Do you want me to introduce them? Hey. It's Nick Benito again. My pleasure to introduce Jeff.
Best of luck, Chris. Jeff.
Every now and again, we'll still call him Jeff. Yeah.
Bones is in the box the whole game.
Where are you going?
I'm was wide open.
The D was gonna.
No, he wasn't. It's Phil. He's slippery.
Another penalty.
What are you doing?
That wasn't me.
That was you again.
Come on, Dumo.
And the overtime is finished.
Yes.
Huge win.
Yes, you guys suck. You guys are so bad.
The worst. I'm not going to try and sound too cocky, but you can ask the other three guys who was the best.
Rusty plays that game every day.
Really well for us.
Knows all the tricks.
Luckily, my team came out on top.
Like, never a doubt, though. Were you worried? Yeah.
No, not at all.
Are you going to go all out for it's in the game?
I'm not
sure.
It's a game.
It's in the game. 3, 2, 1.
EA Sports.
It's a game.
All right, you got it.
There's one guy who hadn't been in a game yet this year, and no one would mistake his name for Jeff. Sidney Crosby was set to make his season debut.
He's such an elite player. What I really admire about Sid is his commitment to play away from the puck, as hard as he plays with the puck. I think that's what separates him from other elite players in the league, is overall two-way game.
You know, he just brings some confidence to our group, knowing we have him back. He's our captain, he's our leader out there, and to have him back in the room is huge and give a big boost to all the guys.
Just the way he plays, the way he handles himself, his presence on and off the ice and in the locker room is something that you can't replace, and having that guy back in your lineup is going to obviously help your team any night.
Malkin is a man wide open. Crosby shooting. He scores! Welcome back, Sid.
I think the type of hockey that he's playing right now is inspiring to his teammates. It's certainly inspiring to his coaching staff. We're certainly appreciative that he's on our bench.
Good speed around the merge. He has a man open. There!
Sidney Crosby in his first game back with the opening goal for the Penguins to set them in flight.
You know, it's a long season, but I'm happy to be back. Playing here is, you know, my first game, and hopefully, can play the rest of the season here.
With any luck, the season will end the same as last, with a permanent place in hockey lore.
It was awesome. We've been kind of waiting to see that, and that was kind of the last thing of our celebration.
Just staying there, Bones. What do we got?
Lemieux, Berto,
Bonino.
Yeah.
Oh, they just squeezed in there. Yeah, wow.
Think they miss me?
That's a tough one.
Right after Gino. I'm like towards the bottom, I think, so. I actually like how mine looks, you know, it's nice and you can read it pretty easy.
Look at this line right here. We really had to squeeze, man.
A lot of names, yeah.
Kunekel, they forgot you. He spelled it right, too.
Cully's up here.
70, 71.
It looks great. I'm next to Hags. Same as usual.
They put the Swedes right next to each other, too.
They did squeeze that.
I think also it's alphabetical.
Kind of went a little wonky with this line down here, eh? He was like, oh, I got tons of space. Oh,
I put my glasses on to see it. When you look at some of the names that are on that Stanley Cup and have won it in the past, to be part of that group is just an incredible feeling. It's a proud moment when you get a chance to look at the engravings, to see our team as part of the Stanley Cup allure.
Sully, I can't, your name's not on here.
Harry Sargent, that's
correct. We'd get that fixed pretty quick anyways.
Rusty's energy and his relentless pursuit out there is what helps our team win games.
He's another player that we missed, and we're glad to have him back.
Yeah, yeah!
We're due. What? We're like a half a play away from getting
one. Here comes Russ with speed, one-on-one. Coming against Letty, pulls the trigger, and Alok was able to stop him.
Yeah! Go, go, go!
Doorman, coming at you.
Yes, he lost the puck. Controller gets it back, though, and goes over to Malkin. A shot right through Malkin, and the Penguins have taken the lead on a goal by number 71. Make me a milkshake, Malkin.
That'll do. Go, go, go.
Woodchuck spun around looking for a stick. And a shot to the net. Crosby, he scores! Sidney Crosby gives the Penguins the lead.
And the game has been completed. Your final score here tonight, the Pittsburgh Penguins 4 and the New York Islanders 2.
Hey, come back. Game-winning goal, we'll see if we get a back-up
call. Oh, yeah.
See you tomorrow. See you tomorrow, boys.
2 days prior to Halloween, the Penguins flew to the scariest part of the state. There's no trick to winning in Philadelphia, but it doesn't hurt when some Malkin magic is on your side.
Let's go, guys, let's go. Good start, we need a good start. Nice job. Oh, you're not ready.
Brady Shen in a confrontation. Now Dailey can't handle the bouncing puck through the poke check. Tempting it and scores. Wayne Simmons cashes in to make it 2-0.
Let's go, guys. Play harder. Finish check. Sam. Behind.
Crosby to Hornquist, to Crosby, the shot, he scores! Incredible shot by Crosby upstairs, and the Penguins are on the board.
Good job, Sid.
Yeah!
Let's go, guys, let's go, field. Field, pass, pass! Yes! Yes! Great, field. Great job, guys.
Awesome play.
What a beautiful pass by Kessel and Malkin. Cashes in.
That baby had eyeballs, Mikey.
Nice pass, Phil. Nice pass.
Come on, boys. Let's go. Phil Dyson.
Malkin. Yeah! And Danny Malkin.
That gives him 300, Mikey.
Tired here?
Oh, I'm so tired.
That a boy.
Good job, guys. Finally, finally. It's work.
It worked.
Flower, great job. Scully, last game in the 30s. Congratulations.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
And GD.
Two days after Halloween, the ageless wonder dressed as a 40-year-old for the first time in Anaheim. Fitting, perhaps, because that's where he started his career almost 20 years earlier.
I guess when you start out, you never really think you'd see your 40th birthday in an NHL uniform. So it's, it's fun. The guys make it fun and something I'll probably be proud of when I'm all done. My boys sang me happy birthday this morning. I had a video waiting on my phone, and I talked to the kids on FaceTime. So when I look back on everything, it's faith and family that have got me to the point that I'm at right now. So when I talk to those guys on a day like today, it's pretty cool. It kind of brings it all together and makes it worthwhile and makes it special.
Happy birthday to you. Hi, Dad. We love you. We miss you. You're going to get a hat trick. You're going to get a goal.
I think anytime you come back to the place that you started, it brings back a lot of memories, especially at a day like today when you turn 40, you can kind of look back over your entire career.
Yeah, I don't feel a day over 48, so it's good, yeah.
That's old. All right, you're starting to look a little slow. Now that you hit 40,
speeding up.
You can really see it. No, you're looking slower.
Oh, slower?
For sure.
Ooh, really? Nobody ever jokes about my age, you know?
Really
caught me off guard.
After all these years, no one jokes about your age.
Oh, hey. Thanks, Chris. Guys like you, that makes me feel young.
That duster really makes you look old.
You look older than me.
Yeah.
I don't know.
They can't be. If they feel or look like me, they can't be in the league anymore. Right? Are you kidding? I wasn't ready. Whoever was moved quick, so I have a pretty good idea. You gotta have your head on a swivel, right?
As the Penguins got ready to face the Ducks, the newest member of the team, Mike Condon, was informed that he had been traded to Ottawa. While one of the longest tenured members, Chris Letang, returned to the lineup.
Penguins move to the road for game number two of a four-game swing. Trying to make it four wins in a row. The Ducks in. Play it right side to Schultz. To back to the net, and he goes in off Gibson.
Holy smokes! Off that redirection. That was a sick play.
Partner, there it is. The give and the go.
Matt Cullen with a rifle shot.
Happy birthday, Matt Cullen. The game winner.
And many more years to come for Mr. Cullen.
Before facing the Kings, Jeff Zadkoff, crowned as Mr. Game One, was presented with his Stanley Cup ring.
Thank you guys very much.
Mr. Game One.
Yeah. I told the boys, if it doesn't say Mr. Game One here, on here somewhere, I don't know, I might have to get re-engraved. Yeah. This could be on the cover at GQ.
It's something that you always have. I'll cherish forever, not only the ring, but the memories that come with it. That's something you can never take away.
It was one of those games I think they're hard to play against. They have a lot of structure through the neutral zone. They try to take your speed away, and credit to them. It's obviously a big point for us. We found a way to tie the game with a big goal by Sid. We got a big penalty kill in the overtime, so there's a lot of positives to draw from as well.
Deflected by Kessel, set up though by Dinsdale. Comes in back, header score. Nick Dowd wins it for the Kings. The final score, Los Angeles 3 and Pittsburgh 2.
Reflecting on seeing something for the first time is always special. But seeing the locker room in San Jose for the first time since last June was on a different level.
You can't help but revisit that memory when you walk into the building. That experience has made such an impression on all of us that we're fortunate enough to be a part of it. But having said that, I think the focus needed to be and had to be on the task at hand.
Just
Yeah, Bob Cooney, hell of a shot, kid. Wow. That remembers me, a young Matt Collins, last year.
Hagelin shoots it towards the net, comes off a goaltender. Now Crosby plays it off him in the backside, it goes in.
And the Penguins are filling the San Jose net tonight.
I certainly give our leadership group a lot of credit for making sure we stayed on task and making sure that we took control of that game and staying in the moment.
Mark Edwards blasts it back to the puck and it goes in off the stick of Crosby. Everything he touches turns to gold.
Nice. And the Pittsburgh Penguins and Matt Murray has posted his second shutout in regular season action.
Good job, boys. Sid, not a bad night. Bonds, first goal.
Oh, man.
Cooney,
what?
Sick shot. Matty boy, shut up. Hey.
The Penguins return home after a four-game road trip. The Penguins did not lose a game outright in that four-game span, and so the Penguins will carry some momentum into this game.
We're certainly pleased with where we are in the standings and the record that we have to this point, but we recognize as a team and as a coaching staff that we have a long way to go.
Logan gets the goal!
I think we've been playing fairly good hockey, but I don't think we've been playing our best. There's always things to build on and there's always things to kind of move forward, and that's been the mindset of each person in our locker rooms, that each day is a new day and you got to continue to work to get better.
It's a daily endeavor, and we're trying to challenge our group each and every day to come to the rink and get better. When our team has that consistency of play, shift in and shift out, game in and game out, because of our commitment level, I think we're a tough team to play against, and we can beat any team in this league.
Let's go, guys, let's go, good shoot.
Hey, let's be ready here, let's go. It's good defense. Nice. Nice play.
Excuse me, Bones.
Is there an excuse for you?
Oh, bottom left. What did you do?
Yeah,
first
you know,
spot on the thing. Easy
to find on the bottom left, right?
Yeah.
That's not a bad spot at all.
Gotta look 10 minutes to find
bottom
Bones.
Row on the
Captain Nick Bonino.
We're in the bunch. That's a tough spot right there, Bones.
Are you after Sid, so that's the number one spot. It says Captain Nick Bonino.